So at this point, once the kernel has doctored this client thread to start executing the server procedure, it can transfer control to the server. So it transfers the control to the server, and so now we're starting to execute the server procedure in the server's address space. And in the server's address space, because A stack has been mapped in, this is also available to the server domain. And the first thing that's going to happen in the server domain is our server stub is going to get into action and take the arguments that are sitting in the A stack and copy them into the stack that the server procedure is going to use. Remember, I told you that the kernel provides a special stack for that purpose, an E stack, execution stack, and that is the stack into which the client, the server stub, is going to copy the A stack arguments into that E stack, and then at that point, the procedure foo is ready to start executing. So at this point, procedure foo is like any normal procedure. It finds the information it wants on the stack. It does its job. Once it is done with executing this procedure, it has to pass back the results to the client. And what is going to happen is that the server stub is going to take the results of this procedure execution and copy them into this A stack. And of course, all of this action is happening in the server domain without any mediation by the kernel. So once the server stub has copied the results into the A stack, at that point, it can trap into the kernel. And this is the vehicle by which the kernel can transfer control back to the client. So it does a return trap. Now, when this return trap happens, there is no need for the kernel to validate this trap as opposed to the call trap, because the up call was made by the kernel in the very first place. And therefore, it is expecting this return trap to happen. And so the kernel doesn't have to do any special validation for this. And at this point, what the kernel is going to do is it is basically going to redoctor the thread to start executing in the client address space. So basically, it knows the return address where it has to go back in order to start executing the client code, and it knows the client's address space, so it's going to redoctor the thread to start executing in the client address space. So when the client thread is rescheduled to execute, at that point, the client stub gets back into action, copies the results that are sitting in the A stack into the stack of the client, and once it has done that, the client thread can continue on with its normal execution. So that's what is going on. And the important point that you notice is that the copying through the kernel that used to happen is now completely eliminated, because the arguments are passed through the A stack into the server, and similarly, the result is passed through the A stack into the client. So let's analyze what we've accomplished in terms of reducing the cost of the RPC in the actual calls that are being made between the client and the server.